In this video, we're looking at two functions that look sort of notationally similar. They both involve a sine function and a square root, but the square root occurs in a different spot, and we want to compare the derivatives of these two functions. Before I start, we'll just do a quick reminder of how do you differentiate a square root function. So if I wanted the derivative with respect to x of square root of x, I just think of it as a power of x. That's x to the 1/2, and then I use the power rule, and I get 1/2 x to the negative 1/2, which is 1 over x to the 1/2, or 1 over the square root. So it simplifies to 1 over 2 root x. All right, so you deal with roots by thinking of them as exponents. So let's look at our first derivative here, the derivative of the square root of the sine of x. So I'm going to think of this as the sine of x raised to the 1/2 power. So my inner function is the sine function. The outer function for the application of the chain rule is the function that raises to the 1/2 power. So I have a thing raised to the 1/2 power, and the chain rule says differentiate with respect to that thing, treating it like a single variable. So in my mind, I'm thinking of sine x as just like a y, and y to the 1/2 differentiated would be 1/2 times that y, which is sine x, to the negative 1/2. And then the chain rule says now you have to tack on the derivative of the interior function with respect to x, which is a cosine. So I could clean it up a little, just writing it all as one big fraction. I'll put the cosine in the numerator. There's a 2 in the denominator. And then this is a 1 over square root sine x. So cosine x over 2 root sine x. Let's see how the other one comes out. The derivative of sine square root of x. Again, I'm going to express that root as a power, so it's x to the 1/2. Okay, now the outer function is the sine function, and the inner function is the square rooting function. So the chain rule says differentiate the sine of this thing with respect to this thing. Well, that just gives you the cosine of that thing. And then the chain rule says you have to tack on the derivative of that interior with respect to x, which is going to be a 1/2 x to the negative 1/2. Just writing everything back in terms of square roots. That's the cosine of the square root of x. And then this piece over here simplifies to 1 over 2 root x. And it's probably best to write it all as one big fraction. So I have the cosine of square root of x divided by 2 root x. And we're done.